This PhysCast deals with simple harmonic motion where dampening is present. Please pause the video and read through the question carefully. We're told we have a lightly damped oscillator, and due to this dampening, the amplitude is decreasing by 3% over each cycle. We're asked to ascertain two things. Firstly, what is the percentage of mechanical energy which is lost in each cycle? And secondly, what's the dampening coefficient if the oscillator is 100 gram mass and the cycle time is 1 second? Let's first remind ourselves about damped oscillatory motion. So what's going to be happening is that my oscillator is going to be oscillating and the amplitude is going to be decreasing with time. This means that some energy is being removed from the system. What dictates how fast that amplitude is decreasing is given by the coefficient of dampening. If we look up or recall the solution for the displacement of my oscillator as a function of time, we get this equation here, which tells me that my displacement as a function of time is given by the amplitude multiplied by this exponential function, which is essentially the envelope function, which tells me how fast my amplitude is decaying, given by how large this term is in front of the t. If the term in front of the t is large, then my exponential function decreases rapidly with time. If the term in front of the t is small, my amplitude stays largely unchanged, I'm lightly damped. So I'm expecting this term b over 2m to be a small number, since I'm told that it's a lightly damped oscillator. The oscillations are given by this cosine function, where the oscillator is oscillating at a frequency which could be a little bit differently from the natural frequency, the square root of k over m. And this difference is determined by, once again, the magnitude of the dampening coefficient. For lightly damped systems, this term here would be small, so I wouldn't expect my oscillation frequency to be different from my natural frequency. Square root of k over m would be the dominant term. So let's have a look at how we can go about doing this. To develop this a little bit further, for part A, I'm asked to find the percentage of mechanical energy which is lost in each cycle. And so here, I want to recall that the energy of my simple harmonic oscillator, if it was conserved, if there was no dampening, then I could get that from just a half times the spring constant K times the amplitude squared for my oscillator. However, what we see here is my amplitude is decreasing with time. At t equals 0, the amplitude is A, but at 1 second later, from my next cycle, my amplitude is 0.97A. So what I think I can do here to find the percentage of mechanical energy which is lost, that means I can look at the change in energy. That's energy final minus energy initial, where the final point is at t equals 1 second, so at my first cycle, and my initial point is going to be at t equals 0. To get that into a percentage, what I need to do is divide by the energy of my initial system. So recalling that the final energy is going to be a half times k times the amplitude, which is 0.97a at 1 second. We're not told what the amplitude is, a as a numerical value. The initial energy I can get from half times k times a squared, and then divide by a half times k times a squared. There are a few terms here which are common, so I've got a half which is common, top and bottom. I've got the spring constant k, which is common top and bottom. In fact, even the a's are common top and bottom. But what I will do, first of all, is I'll evaluate the brackets. So 0.97 squared is going to be 0.9409 multiplied by a squared, so minus 1, with an a squared factorized out the back. And that's all divided by a squared, so now my a squareds cancel. What we can see is the change in mechanical energy as a ratio to the initial energy is going to be this difference divided by 1. And that difference is minus 0.9409 0.0591. To get that into a percentage, I just need to multiply by 100%. So that's really a difference of minus 5.9%. So the amount of mechanical energy which has been lost is I've lost almost 6%, and I can tell that it's been lost is because there's a negative sign in front. The negative sign tells me energy has been lost. If my final energy was larger than my initial energy, then that would be energy which the system had gained. The second part of my problem, part B, I'm asked to ascertain what is the dampening coefficient. So that is, what is the value for B if the mass that is oscillating is 100 grams and cycle time is 1 second. The way I can do this, once again, is to evaluate this expression here at T is equal to 1 second, realizing that I would have my amplitude A multiplied by E to the minus B times the time, which is 1 second, divided by 2 times the mass, which is 0.1, multiplied by this cosine function. However, my cosine function should just be 1, because I'm at the first cycle point. So at T is equal to 1 second here, I'm saying that my amplitude is going to be also a maximum. That cosine function is just like returning 1. And I know that at that time, t equals 1 second, the amplitude has been decreased to 0.97 of its original amplitude. So hopefully you can see from there that actually the A's cancel, and I can use logarithms to evaluate this expression. So if I take the log of both sides, I get the log of 0.97 on the right-hand side. That's going to be equal to the log of my exponential function just returns the index. So I end up with minus b over 0.2. b will equal to the negative of 0.2 multiplied by the log 0.97. And that equals 0.0061 as my coefficient. And it has the units of kilograms per second. So that's my answer for part B.